The term synergy has been described in many settings and situations of life, including mechanics, technical systems, human social life, and many more. In all cases, synergy describes the fact that a system in which the combination and interaction of two or more agents or forces is such that the combined effect is greater than the sum of their individual effects. This definition implies that there are three possible ways of such an interaction of agents or forces. These forces could simply not affect each other or no interaction, or they could produce a greater than expected result or synergy, or they could lead to a result that is less than the sum of the individual effects or antagonism. Interactions of biologically active agents are an important aspect of pharmacology and biomedicine. In this context, interaction describes the biological activity that results from the presence of several drugs at the same time. Such situations occur in numerous clinical situations, such as combinations of cytotoxic drugs in the treatment of cancer, and infections require lower doses of each drug to obtain better therapeutic effects with less side effect toxicity. Combinations of antibiotics likewise combine better efficiency with fewer side effects and reduced development of resistance. Many serious clinical situations require administration of several drugs simply because of multiple therapeutic indications. Although in such a case drug combinations are not formulated to look for synergies, the interactions of these drugs need to be assessed. The effect of one drug may be augmented by another drug that does not produce such an effect on its own. In all these cases, multiple drugs are administered and will show some form of interaction, synergistic, antagonistic, or none. Methods to determine and quantify drug interactions are thus an essential tool in pharmacology. What is synergy, additivity, and antagonism? To illustrate the definition of these concepts, let's imagine the following scenario. A woodcutter is able to cut 10 trees in a day. He is joined by a second woodcutter, also able to cut down 10 trees in a day. Together, they manage to cut 15 trees in one day. How do we describe this situation? One approach is that cutter A achieves 10 trees per day, our expected value. Addition of cutter B results in 15 trees being cut, so there is synergy. This conclusion is correct if we only considered the effect of one agent and whether it was affected by another one being added. Conversely, one would say that with two cutters, each able to cut 10 trees per day, the expectation value is 20 trees per day. If only 15 are achieved, they are antagonizing each other. This is the application of additivity. Clearly, the combined effect is subadditive. 20 trees would be just additive, and more than 20 would mean synergy. Mechanistically, one might argue that if cutter A works on a tree, then cutter B would not work on the same tree. Their action would be mutually exclusive, and the additive result would be expected. If, however, they are willing to work at the same tree together, they will be able to cut this tree in a much shorter time. In this case, they would be able to cut more than 20 trees in a day, and their action would be mutually non-exclusive, leading to synergy. Similar to the above-mentioned scenario, synergy may be observed where two drugs that only act on one target protein can show synergism. In such a case, we can study the interaction of the drugs mechanistically and determine why and how several drugs can reinforce each other or why they do not. Let us assume a simple enzyme following the laws of mass action and Michaelis-Menten kinetics. In the simplest case, this enzyme has an active site where substrate is being converted into product and possesses one or several specific binding sites for inhibitors. A competitive inhibitor binds to the active site of the enzyme, displacing the substrate. Thus, a mixture of two purely competitive inhibitors will only ever target the active site. This is known as mutually exclusive binding. If only the simplest mechanistic case is considered, one would not expect a second competitive inhibitor to have any notable effect on the first one, other than raising the total amount of inhibitory molecules. In case of non-competitive inhibition, the inhibitor binds to a location on the enzyme different from the active site. Assuming that bound inhibitor converts the enzyme into an inactive state, presence of a non-competitive inhibitor simply lowers the amount of active enzyme molecules. In the non-competitive inhibition, there are states where both substrate and inhibitor are bound to the enzyme. The effect of several non-competitive inhibitors applied together raises the question if synergy can be observed in such a simple system. If two non-competitive inhibitors bind to the same site on their target enzyme, this inhibitory site can either be occupied by inhibitor A or B, but not by both inhibitors at the same time. This would be a case of mutually exclusive binding of two inhibitors. If one inhibitor is present and the second one added, one may observe indeed a greater extent of inhibition, but this would only be due to larger amounts of inhibitory molecules being present. At all times, we could predict the total amount of inhibition by summations. In the simplest molecular case, two inhibitors targeting the same site would produce an additive effect only. If, however, two different binding sites for non-competitive inhibitors exist on an enzyme, two inhibitors may bind simultaneously. If two inhibitors have specific, independent sites on the enzyme, we will observe states where the enzyme indeed has two inhibitors bound. These states cannot exist if both inhibitors bind to the same site. Thus, if two inhibitors are able to bind simultaneously, we have a case of mutually non-exclusive binding. Here, presence of the second inhibitor will not only give an additive effect by increasing the number of inhibitory molecules, but will generate additional inhibited states of the enzyme. Therefore, on a molecular level, we would expect a synergistic effect of two such inhibitors. Let us consider another simple situation where two drugs, A and B, are combined. If drug A has an effect and drug B has no effect. If in combination they have an effect that is greater than that of drug A, then it is enhancement or potentiation. We can describe the effect simply as percent enhancement or fold of potentiation. If A and B alone each has an effect, then in combination they may produce a synergistic, an additive, or an antagonistic effect. By definition, synergism is an effect that is more than additive, whereas the definition for antagonism is an effect that is less than additive. Clearly, defining what is an additive effect is the most crucial criterion for defining synergism and antagonism. Of course, in real life, the situation is more complicated, as mechanisms of enzyme or receptor activity are more complex. Furthermore, medical intervention is not only directed at single proteins, but at entire pathways or controlling structures, such as transcription factors, that initiate or control biochemical processes. Some therapies, such as cancer chemotherapy, they interfere with a complete living organism. In addition, many drugs interfere with metabolism of other drugs, including drug absorption, tissue distribution, and clearance. Thus, a substance B that slows down clearance of an active drug A by blocking metabolizing enzymes or excretion may lead to a higher effective concentration of A that remains in the body for a longer time. As a result, one would notice a greater effect of drug A when given together with B, although the two drugs have completely different modes of action. While certainly the combination of these two drugs would have a synergy, but their combination is synergistic in practical application, not by the strict definition. In summary, although it is easy to define synergy, additivity and antagonism as the interaction between two or more components such that the combined effect is superior, equal or inferior, respectively, to the expected sum of individual effects, in most biological systems, the mechanisms of action are not known and are too complex to work with. Defining synergy as simple as a combined effect that is greater than the sum of their individual effects might not be sufficient. Thus, the use of pertinent models and methods to analyze drug combination data is needed.